This conference will now be recorded.
Oh, Lakshmi, you can continue.
Okay. Well, just before going with the understanding what concepts and how we will take the flow, I just want to understand, are you working, Kavya?
Actually, I was working with HCL. I was into support role. I have no idea about this testing and all.
Okay.
I'm very much new to this.
Well, so what about your qualification? You are even from the IT?
I'm from IT.
Okay. So if you're from IT, you understand what is meant by programming, right? What is a database? These terms at least
exactly. I know.
So might be in your college time, you might have understood C language, C++, right?
Yes.
During your college, the graduate, right?
Yes.
But even though you don't have any experience into the technically into the programming domain, okay? But if you want to switch from any domain into the IT sector, you can start with the testing, okay? So not only IT members, IT field, so anyone, participants, not even from non-IT field also can learn the testing and start working in it. Okay. So as you have put a request for the QA, right? So QA, see, it is a testing. So what you understand with the basic testing word? So I don't need any technical definition. Just a general. If I won't say, I need to test it. Test anything, okay? Test your electronic product. Test anything. Test a pen, whether it is writing, test a laptop. Anything can be tested, right?
Yes.
So after testing, it's like the market, so you need to test. So what things you feel like you understand by testing it?
Testing means. Need to know how it works, how it is working.
Exactly.
Yes.
Working, yeah. And what are the parameters you try to check? Working means, okay, if I'm testing the laptop, if it just turns on, is it enough?
No, whether, if it is a laptop, we'll see all the functions are working.
Functions means, do you have any set list to check whether they're working?
We'll see whether audio is working. Screen. Applications.
You have a set of applications, right? What you want to. So these all things are working or not, you check. Means you already have one checklist what to be tested. Just if laptop is just turning on and off, that doesn't mean that laptop is tested. That is one point. Okay. Unless it turns on, you can't go and test the next step.
Yes.
So apart from turning on and off, you need to check with your checklist. You have your expectations. What a laptop requirement should be there. If a laptop is used for testing, you should know that for testing, what are the things necessary, are they or not. You have your checklist. So you have a checklist and you're trying to check it, correct?
Yes.
And next thing, while testing, if all the requirements are meeting, then only you say successfully, perfectly will be done, right?
Yeah.
If audio is working, but when I'm talking, my voice is blunt. Is it a right laptop?
No.
If a screen, screen is shared, screen is available, but the screen is upside down, okay? It is half visible, half not. Is it acceptable?
No.
So apart from testing this, your checklist, you should also check the quality.
Yes, right? Quality, yes.
So You can say testing in simple words as as we're going to test now, not the laptop. When you're in IT field, applications are developed, right, by the company.
Yes.
So you're going to test the application, software applications. So these applications, when you're testing, you try to check. Now, who is giving the projects to the companies? Some clients, right?
Yes.
So they have the requirements. So reading out these requirements, you try to implement in the application. You have to develop based on it.
Yes.
So after developing, your testing starts, right?
Yes.
So whatever the testing software application you're testing, you should check whether the client requirements, client expectations are available or not. Right?
Yes.
In the application, that is one point. Okay, client expectations are there, but are they working properly or whether they are up to the quality? Also to be checked. When client requirements and quality is maintained, then you can say application is successfully tested without any errors. Quality means what? No errors, right?
Yeah, yes.
No bugs. Then we say it is a quality application. Then you can, the client can accept the application and run. So this is nothing but a testing application. Okay, let us take, is it clear, Kavya?
Yes, yes, everything clear.
Now, suppose your client is saying he wants one application to be developed, okay? In that application, different functionalities will be there.
Okay.
Suppose you take a Facebook. Facebook has so many functionalities. Login is one functionality, right?
Yes.
You have a login under it. Login, you also have a logout for it. You have a chat, right? You can create account. You can do so many things in this application, right? So each of thing is nothing but one functionality. One function, it is doing some task, right?
Yes.
We call it as a functionality. Now, as a tester, you need to test each and everything. Then only you say Facebook is tested.
Yeah.
So suppose I ask you to do a testing for login. So login has to be initially coded by the developers, developed, correct?
Yes.
So means it would look something like this, username and a field for it, text field, right? Password.
Yes.
Password field. Okay, and suppose you have a button here, okay button, where you need to submit it, click, right? And this is your login screen.
Yeah.
This is given to you and asked to test. So how will you test as a normal tester?
Yeah, we'll give the user user details, password.
Password, okay. And click on button. And you'll check whether it is going to the home page, your login home page, or whether it is showing you and some error.
Yeah.
Correct? If you're entering wrong password, it'll show you error. If you're giving credentials, it should go to the home page.
Yeah.
This is what you need to test. This is the expected page, and this is the input. You have to give an input, and this is the current page where you need to start.
Yeah.
So if you are doing it manually, first step, you'll find on this, open this application and find manually the box. As we understand, see it and understand, this is a username field. You go and click here and enter data. Similarly, password. And you read the button and click over it with the mouse. And based on the page it is landing up, you verify whether it is home page or error and conclude whether test case is passed or failed, right?
Yes.
Now suppose, okay, this is successfully done. Your login is working. Now if client says this login has to be tested for 1 lakh user input data, can you do it?
No.
Okay, yeah, if you take put some patience and time, you may test some 100 users or
Yeah.
something at max, right?
Yes.
But this is
Yes.
not the right usage of a tester. You are unnecessarily wasting or occupying a tester for a whole day for just doing some automatic work, just passing the data and clicking.
Yeah.
You're not using the resource properly, the tester.
No.
Okay? So, such type of work where it is taking, suppose to test 1 lakh users, if you do it manually also, it may take 10 days, 20 days, maybe.
Yeah. Yes.
So, 20 days unnecessary work you have been done, you told the tester to do it. Right? It's not a right
Yeah.
way of using the resource.
Yes.
So, if such requirements are there, if you want to test the functionality for huge test data, then I can go for automation. So, under testing, you can do by two ways. One is manually, and another is automation. Getting?
Okay. Yeah.
So, testing can be done by two ways. One is manual, the one which you did or now. You have entered username, password, clicked on a button, and verified. That's a manual, right? Second
Yeah.
is automation. So automation means you may write some code and you may tell the tool to execute it.
Okay.
Suppose the same login functionality I want to test for 1 lakh users. So what you do? You write a script. The script as you do a manual. First step, what I'll write? Find the username text box.
Okay.
Username text box. Second step, what I'll write a script. Okay, how to write the script that we'll be learning later, but these are the
Okay.
instructions how to do. Then I
Okay.
say enter data to the field after finding, right?
Yeah.
Then third step, find password text box, right? Then fourth step, enter data to it. Then fifth step, find the button. And sixth step, you have to click over it. Click button. And
Yeah.
seventh step, check the page. The result, check the result, you can say shortly. Okay, so these instructions you may write in a sort of a program and run it. Once you run it, but okay, entering the data to that field, anyways, you will try to read it from Excel file, where Excel file is having all 1 lakh records. So one by one, you'll write the logic in such a way, it will try to read one by one row and pass it to these fields. So this script will be executed 1 lakh times by your tool within no time.
Okay.
So that is known as an automation. You write a code in such a way as you do a manual testing, and once you execute it, the same functionality will be repeated for as much test data you have, and you get the report as well. Okay, that's an
Okay.
automation. Now, what is the second scenario where automation is needed? First scenario we have understood here is when you have to need to test with multiple test data, right? When you have a huge data to test, you can go for automation. Second scenario is what? When new implementations are happening. When new implementations are done, you can do automation. New implementation means what? Suppose you have some applications, release one, correct? Release one
Yeah.
is in the market, antivirus release one is there in the market, people are using it, now they want to add new features to it, correct? Means existing application, you want to add some more features. Once added, it will become, it will come into the market as release 2, correct?
Yes.
So already release 1, the functionalities in the release 1 were already tested. Okay. To those tested functionalities, you are adding new features, new functionalities.
Yes.
Now to say that release 2 is tested, will you test the R1 release 1 functionalities once again, which are already tested?
I mean, I guess we have to add both, and I mean, like R2 we have to test.
Yes, R2, yeah, to say that R, to test R2, R2 is nothing but old features plus new features.
Okay, we have to check whether these features added to R1 is compatible or something like that.
Correct. When new things are coming to the application, may happen the old features are unstable.
Yes.
That may happen.
Yeah.
For example, you were having a phone with only calling features and SMS feature earlier. It was working perfectly. Then you added WhatsApp to it. Now, once after adding WhatsApp, you should check whether you are able to call or not, correct?
Yeah.
So that it doesn't, new features don't impact the functionalities of old functionalities, old features.
Yeah.
You have to test also the old features.
Yes.
But old features were already manually tested. So unnecessary, will you do again testing once again manually of the old features? No.
No.
It will take more time, right? Yeah. Already they were tested. Why will I test once again? But I need to test it.
Yeah.
Then I can do a regression testing. Okay. Regression testing. Regression testing means, suppose in release 1, I have 60 features with there, requirements. Okay. So out of 60, I don't need to test all 60. Important things I can take out of 60. Only those important functionalities, I have to test it by writing such script. They were already manually tested. Now I'll write a script for only few of them, important functionalities, and run them. That process is known as a regression testing.
Okay.
Yeah. So in these two scenarios, we may need automation, because this is not possible to do manual testing, because that will take a long time. So we need the automation.
Okay.
The need of automation. And what is manual? Manual means doing the work on your own. A tester will find, enter data, click, check everything, make a report, everything he will do on his own. But the same work is done with the help of a tool, by writing the script by a tester. That's an automation.
Okay.
Is that clear? Any questions?
No. Okay.
Now in this automation, you find many tools in market for automation.
Okay.
But automation tools, but two are more in use. That is Selenium and second one UFT or Quality Center. But there are differences between these two. Quality Center is a licensed tool. It costs more. So some companies may use, but most of the companies are shifting their projects now to Selenium because it is an open source technology.
Okay.
So Selenium is open source. So you can download that file Selenium freely from the site and configure to your system.
Okay.
And this Selenium can work on any operating system, any OS, Mac, machine, Linux, Windows, anything. No constraint. Okay. And any browser. You can automate your application on any browsers also.
Okay.
IE, Safari, Chrome, anything. But UFT has a constraint. UFT is a licensed tool where you can download only on Windows operating system. And it can automate only on IE browser.
Okay.
That's a limitation. Now, next is, as UFT is a licensed tool, everything gets packed and given to you. Okay?
Yes, yes.
But Selenium is an open source. Everything you have to search and do little bit effort to collect them. Means after execution your code, you don't get a report here in Selenium. But UFT gives you a report of your execution. But you have a solution for it in Selenium as well. You can add, use the test ng and generate the reports.
Okay. What is test ng?
Is that tool? It is a framework through which you add to your project and generate the reports, get the reports.
Okay.
And some more features are there using test ng, using annotations, making test cases, parallel testing, priority setting. All this you can do with test ng.
Okay. Okay.
Now these are some of the features you can say using Selenium. And one more thing, Selenium can be used with different technologies, languages like Java. You can work Selenium with Java, Ruby, Python projects, C#, .NET, all these different projects, different languages, Selenium with Java project, Selenium with Ruby project, Selenium with Python project, you can do. But even though it supports different languages, but most of the applications you find Selenium with Java openings also, career-wise, opportunities-wise as well.
Okay.
Because of the features of Java technology as compared to other technologies. So Java technology is platform independent, object oriented, OOPS concept, right? Because
yes,
of those, you find more openings projects with Selenium, with Java. But UFT, it only supports the VB script. Only one scripting language it understands.
Okay.
So these are the some of the features you can compare with UFT, the Selenium.
Okay.
Yeah. So as in this course, we are going to learn Selenium with Java. So first, initially, we will understand Java concept. Okay, as you're doing with manual as well, first we will start with manual content.
Okay. Is it mandatory to learn manual, to learn automation?
Yes,
because
any project, you don't start with automation. See, as we understood why you need automation, when multiple data comes into picture, then you go for automation. Otherwise, you do it manually.
Yes, yes, yes.
Two versions are there, then you automate it. Others manually. Any application comes into picture, first you have to do manually. Wherever necessary, you will do automation.
Okay.
You will not automate a complete project, never. Only few functionalities where multiple data regression needed, there you try to implement automation.
Okay.
So first, manually is required. Okay. So in this manual thing, what is the life cycle? Life cycle of a project, how to capture the defects, how to write the test cases, how to see the test scenarios. Getting?
Yeah.
What is the format of them? What is the job of every employee in your team to whom you will be reporting? What will be your job role as a tester?
Okay.
So what would be the documents you will be creating? These are all things we will learn under manual.
Okay.
After that, once manual is done, we will start with Selenium. But before moving to Selenium, we understand Java concepts.
Okay.
So the Java coding, which is required for your Selenium understanding, we will study.
Okay, after is it like that, deep? I mean, like, is it into core Java or else like basics or?
Core Java, the basic Java you need, core Java concepts. Like,
okay, just, I mean, is it not like full of coding, right?
Nothing like that. I need a concept, what is a class, what is an object, variable, how to declare methods, how to call them, right?
Okay.
What is the concept? I don't need any logic of Java, but I need the concepts of Java where I would use them in my Selenium. The coding will be of Selenium.
Okay, got it.
Means you can say, where will I write a Selenium code? I should have some space, right? Where should I write platform? I'll take the Java platform. Means the body is of Java, the soul is of Selenium. The content is of Selenium.
Got it.
So I'm filling the Selenium commands inside Java syntax. So after that, we'll start with Selenium. What are the different components of Selenium? And what is the testing in it? What are the different frameworks you have? And how to, even sometimes they ask also in Selenium, Maven project creation. So what is a Maven? How to create it? And what is the difference between normal framework and Maven framework? All these things will be understanding once we start Selenium.
Okay.
Yeah, you can just go through the course content. What we have discussed, the same thing you will find it there.
Okay. Course content is not yet shared, I guess. Like, I'll ask Srinivas to share it with me.
Yeah, just a minute.
And
glance as well. Yeah, tell me.
How the opportunity? Right now, I'm not working. It's been 1.5 months that I resigned my job. So I just want to learn and get into something.
Yes.
Testing or like this. So that's why I prefer testing. Okay. So how are the opportunities? Like, will I be able to? I mean, with this training, will I be able to work on the projects? So that's
obviously you can put an experience up till 7+ years of experience. Seven plus.
Actually, okay. I just have 3.5 years of experience totally.
Then no worries, you can start with any soon after completion of the manual, you can start trying for the job.
Okay, and I also have a doubt, are there any certifications to do, and will that add an advantage in my resume, like how it goes?
See, as Selenium is not a licensed one, right? It is an open source, so there's nothing like, as we have a certification from Oracle or Sun Microsystem for Java, right? Selenium don't have any particular company who takes care of its branded Selenium. It's an open source. But there are vendors who provide certification for it. They conduct exam and give you a certification. But that certification is not like a Oracle certified kind of thing. They are just the vendors.
So you say that's not mandatory to do, right?
It's not mandatory, but
Will that add advantage?
Yes. It is based on the companies. Some companies only prefer the certified peoples, right?
Okay.
So in that case, it is up to you what kind of company job you're looking at, or you're planning, like initially you want to just go and enter the job, and after that you want to take a certification, and then once you gain some experience plus certification, move to the new company with a new position.
Okay. What's the pricing for certification?
I need to check it, but now I'm not sure what is the pricing there.
Okay. No issues. What is the certification name so that I can go through?
Yeah, I'll give you the complete details tomorrow. The price, the vendor, everything.
Sure. No issues.
Is the vendor examination?
Sorry, could you please repeat?
IST. Yeah. Okay. So that will give you the certification it conducts. But I would say that before going with the certification, understand the course.
Yeah, okay. Okay.
First, start a job in testing.
Okay. Okay.
As you work, you get more experience. Okay. Then, after starting a job of 2 or 1 month or 3 months, you prepare for the certification and take the examination.
Okay. Okay.
So examination done, after 1 or 2 years with the certification, you can shift the job as well with a good package and experience.
Okay. Cool.
So it is, you can plan. Okay, it's not like that. It's fixed. It depends on.
Okay. Sure. Just for an idea, I've asked you. Thank you.
But these are the topics in manual testing which we are going to study. The bugs, the tracking of the bugs, everything, unit test, different types of testing, levels of testing. Okay. What are the life cycles of a testing? Okay. Right now, whatever the projects are, they are the agile projects. What is the difference between agile projects and other types of SDLC, software development life cycle? Means there are different models are there, waterfall model, agile model. So we'll be understanding all these terms, environment, what application, which environment you can suggest or suitable for the client. What are the different meetings you come across when you're working? What are the different documents you create while work?
Okay.
Okay. So these all terms will come in the manual. So once you start with the Selenium, there the Selenium commands, basic commands, advanced commands. So Selenium testing, how to find an element identification, what are the different tools you use for it, okay, basic the methods in it, how to identify the links, all the web elements, the radio buttons, text boxes, buttons, links, images, handling the alerts, pop-ups, window handling, frame handling, web tables, advanced concepts, wait statements. So all these things, capturing the screenshot, the frameworks, the page object model framework, page factory, the test ng concepts. Okay, and you have some of the Java concepts.
Okay.
Okay. So this is how we will be taking the course.
Okay. Okay, I'll go through the course content. That's not an issue. Yeah.
Okay, so what is the time you're looking at, Kavya?
8 o'clock to 9 o'clock is fine for me. Like, what is your feasible time?
Yeah, we can plan that. Also, like, how about morning? And you're available, right?
Morning, no. Anytime evening is fine for me.
Okay.
Anyways, I'll get back to you. Like, I'll update Srinivas on this. Okay. Lakshmi,
any questions you have from your end?
No. Like, whatever you told right now is, for now it is fine for me.
Okay then. Thanks, Kavya.
Thank you so much, Lakshmi. Good night.
Good night.